Stephen James Simmons. I am a 5'11" white Anglo-Saxon Protestant, and this is my story. I was born in a hospital and had lived over 18 years when a very large number of teenagers made the collective mistake of nominating me for elected speaker. And so here we are today. I stand before you pleased to see that a handful of people could turn up to watch this lovely group of young men and women walk across this floor and begin the exhilarating and terrifying life beyond grade school. If you will humor me, I'm going to take a moment during this graduation ceremony to talk about a different graduation ceremony for a different school. This leads to a larger point, so bear with me. My brother, who is currently sitting somewhere amongst you stunningly attractive people, walked this floor 2 years ago. For my brother, a piece of paper and a handshake didn't seem enough. He was born April 20th, 1990, 3 months early and just over 2 pounds, along with a plethora of health issues and learning disabilities. My dad could hold him in his hand like this. Once the initial hurdle of getting him to breathe independently was conquered, the ride only got faster. Doctors and aides helped him through elementary and middle school, and high school was extended to 6 years to help him deal with the workload. My family dealt with frequent hospital trips, one of which almost left me without a brother. And yet, 21 years after his terrifying birth, on June 1st, 2011, I sat right up there and watched my brother, Samuel Scott Simmons Jr., graduate from J.L. Mann High School. My family was there. Samuel's high school aide, who had been his guide and friend for 6 years, had been there. But there were others I wish had been there. Those who said he couldn't do it, that he was too frail. Because right then, as Samuel received his diploma, he had proven them wrong. He had been fighting for 2 decades, and he had won. My brother isn't the only one who had to fight to get here. That sea of fashionable caps is filled with people who battled the odds to be in this arena. The scars of their battles may not have left physical marks, as with Samuel, but that doesn't mean the fight was any less painful. They've had to overcome obstacles I can't begin to imagine. Problems with friends, problems at home. The biggest problem I have at my home is the staircase. Adolescence is when we learn to think on our own. We also learn to stress and to hurt and to struggle on our own. Everyone graduating today has had their share of struggles. Private struggles they never shared, because it was their fight to fight. So today, I congratulate you all. You fought the fight and you won. Whether the struggle was physical, mental, internal, or external, you overcame it. I'd like to recognize Nadia Glover, our official spirit of Wade Hampton. She fought to be in that chair. She has struggled with things I have never had to face. She did it. She won. All of you won. If you will excuse me as I use the most overused and cliche illusion in all of creation, look at a caterpillar as it becomes a butterfly. It wraps itself in a cocoon and emerges again as a butterfly. We don't see what goes on inside its cocoon. That's the caterpillar's fight. We don't see a beaten caterpillar rip open the cocoon, yell, "I give up," and crawl away to sulk on a nearby leaf. We see a beautiful, triumphant butterfly. Today, I see about 400 beautiful, triumphant butterflies. I wish I could say I knew everyone here. To many of these seniors, I'm now the bespectacled nerd who called everyone butterflies. I wish I could say I knew everyone here. I transferred to Wade Hampton after a year at J.L. Mann, after everyone had formed their social circles, so coming to Wade Hampton was basically like coming to reality after a life of homeschooling. No offense to homeschooled, even though that was offensive. Sorry. But when I came to Wade Hampton, something stood out. The students. Within my first hour in class, 3 different people who had never met me before in their lives started conversations with me. Students at Wade Hampton talk to you, get to know you, make you feel welcome. Now, as I'm saying this, I know half the kids sitting behind me are thinking of students that did the opposite, but I'm here to make you guys look good, so just love thy neighbor until we're out of here. Keep in mind, these are the guys that raise hundreds of thousands of dollars for charity on a yearly basis, over $206,000 this year. Think about what you could buy with that. 3,000 pairs of shoes. A shirt at Anthropology. You were looking at a senior class that has been offered almost $15 million in scholarships. These kids have done incredible things. Just in the past year, my friend, Harlan Haskins, co-directed a Shakespeare play. Romy Orig spent 3 months in Moyobamba, Peru, helping those less fortunate. Alexis Dillard literally made history with her basketball playing. 28 seniors qualified for Palmetto Fellows, and I rewatched all of Parks and Recreation on Netflix. And the number of seniors who have received Fulbright scholarships is amazing. I am not one of them, but I applaud those who are, figuratively, because I need to move on. I'm going to close with a quote from my favorite president, Theodore Roosevelt. He kept going despite the opposition. Remember, this is the guy that got shot in the chest while giving a speech, then finished his speech before seeking medical attention. In response to skeptics, he said this: "It is not the critic who counts, not the man who points out how the strong man stumbles, or where the doer of deeds could have done them better. The credit belongs to the man who is actually in the arena, whose face is marred by dust and sweat and blood, who strives valiantly, who errs and comes short again and again, because there is no effort without error and shortcoming, but who does actually strive to do the deeds, who at the best knows in the end the triumph of high achievement, and who at the worst, if he fails, at least fails while daring greatly, so that his place shall never be with those cold and timid souls who know neither victory nor defeat." Bang. You are about to start the rest of your lives. That's a big deal. People will get in your way. People will tell you you can't. That's a part of life. But you keep going. My brother kept going. Mr. Roosevelt kept going. You kept going. You fought your fights, and now take all of this in because you have thousands of witnesses to your victory. There were failed tests, lost jobs, an absence of loving parents, deaths in the family. None of that stopped you. You soldiered on. You fought your way through a cocoon of hardship, and you emerged with your wings spread wide. You knocked high school's socks off. Now the world's socks better get ready. Grade school is over. And so is my speech.
It is now my pleasure and honor to present to you the Wade Heaven High School Class of 2013. Seniors, please prepare to receive your diplomas.
Hudson White Payton with honor. Frederick McKenzie Perry IV with high honor.